In this video, I'm going to show you what I think is one of the cheapest and best ways to stream on Facebook Live or YouTube. Hello, I'm Stephen Ballast. Welcome to my channel where I explore worship technology solutions. Live streaming is a really popular topic right now. Everybody is looking at how to get their church's live stream up and running. So I'm going to show you one method for streaming to Facebook Live using an external camera or a switcher with OBS software on a PC. There are several reasons you'd want to use an external camera through a video interface, like this Blackmagic Intensity Shuttle. First, it allows you to use better cameras with better lenses, longer zoom capability, and more control over exposure, and use external audio inputs, all of which are important in a production environment. Also, this setup lays the groundwork for growing your video system. If you start with one camera, just add a switcher and another camera, and you've got a multi-camera setup, still using all the equipment that you invested in originally. Let's talk through the hardware I have here, and some gotchas to look out for with the Intensity Shuttle. On the input, I'm using one of our production cameras with an HDMI output, but you could also use a switcher with an HDMI output. The Intensity Shuttle takes that in through a full-size HDMI connector, and then connects to your computer through a regular USB 3 connection. Some people struggle to get video working through the Intensity Shuttle, and I think the reason is an overlooked technical spec or limitation in its specification. If you look at the video standards that it supports, it doesn't support 1080p 60. Unfortunately, a lot of cameras output this format on their HDMI connector, especially a lot of cheap consumer cameras. For instance, I couldn't get the usual entry-level camera that I recommend, the Canon R800, to work directly connected to the shuttle because its HDMI output defaults to 1080p 60. Even if you set the camera to record at its lower bit rates, which are supposed to be 720 resolution, the HDMI output still stays at 1080p 60. If I ran it through a format converter that forced the output to 720p, which is supported, then it worked fine. So, what this comes down to is if you're going to use the Intensity Shuttle, which for about $200 is a good video interface, just be aware of what the limitations are and pay really close attention to the video standards that your camera supports. And use one that lets you control what video standard the camera is set to. If you're using a switcher like an ATEM, just set your video standard to something other than 1080p 60. And if you're streaming on Facebook Live, there really isn't any reason to be doing anything over 720p. Okay, let's talk about how to configure the software on the computer. First, you'll need to download and install the Blackmagic desktop video drivers. I always go straight to their website and download the latest drivers, rather than use the drivers they send on the SD card, because they're usually really old. Then, download and install OBS from their website. I've got the links to all these downloads, as well as the hardware I'm using, down in the description of this video. Once you've got all that installed, one quick check you can do to make sure your hardware is working correctly is to open up the Blackmagic software Media Express. This was installed as part of the desktop video drivers. In it, you can verify that you're getting a picture from your camera. It's a good troubleshooting tip that you can use to verify that everything on the Blackmagic capture device side is happy and working. Once you have your camera connected, open up OBS, and first you're going to add a source and select Blackmagic device, and then create new. Select Intensity Shuttle and click OK. Then we need to go to the Settings button and click on the Stream Settings. Select Facebook Live as your service, default server should work fine, and then enter your stream key that you got from your Facebook Connect page. That's all you need to do to configure OBS. The rest of the defaults for Facebook Live should work fine, but I'm going to show you a few other settings in case you need to configure them. Under the output settings is where you can adjust your bitrate. The default of 2500 is probably fine to start with, depending on your internet speed. Then also in video settings, it should default to an output of 1280 by 720, since this is the highest resolution you can send to Facebook. Click OK and you're ready to start streaming to your Facebook page. Just click the Start Streaming button and you should see your video show up in the preview window on Facebook. If you're having issues with reliability, your stream dropping out or getting glitchy, that's when you'd want to adjust your video size and bitrate settings. Try halving your resolution to 640 by 360 and also half your bitrate to 1000. Most issues with video streaming are going to be due to the reliability of your internet connection or the horsepower of your computer, so lowering your bitrate can help you with both of those. Your internet connection should always have at least double the upload bandwidth as the bitrate you stream at. And that's it. You should be up and streaming on Facebook. Hey, if you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and be sure and subscribe to my channel. Until next time, bye.